climbed up to the highest mountain. Looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Went down into the deepest valley. Looked all around down there, couldn't find nobody.
The church is supposed to be unified under the one Spirit of Jesus Christ. The church has one hope. The church has one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God the Father.
Nobody greater, nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater, no. Nobody greater than you.
If you would turn your attention once again to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3. I want to lift up verse 11 for our text this morning. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 11. If you have it, say amen. And it reads, "What other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Christ Jesus?" Amen. I want to share this morning from the subject of the right foundation. The right foundation. Let us pray. Father God, we come now and we ask that your Holy Spirit, which is already moving among us, will continue to move and to be active, will continue to anoint and to deliver and to set free. And we pray, God, that as your Holy Spirit is moving now, that you would anoint us afresh to receive from you. And anoint us afresh, O God, to share your word with your people. God, I ask that you would overshadow me now by your Holy Spirit. Use me for your will and your glory. And I pray, God, that you would open our ears and help us to listen. Open our eyes, for we want to see Jesus. And then open our hearts that we might receive him. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the blessed Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. The right foundation. Many of us are probably familiar with the story of the three little pigs. Amen. That probably was one of your first stories you heard in kindergarten or first grade or somewhere in elementary school. And we know the story about the three little pigs, that they had an adversary called the big bad wolf, and that they decided one day that they were going to build houses. One built his out of straw, and the other built his out of sticks, while the third built his out of brick. They all went home and were enjoying their little homes when the big bad wolf showed up at the first house, and he declared, "Open up and let me in." Which the little piggy replied, "Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin." Amen. Y'all know it. And it said that he huffed and he puffed and he blew the straw house down. That little pig ran to his brother's home that was made out of sticks. And it said he showed up there and he knocked on that door and said, "Open up and let me in." To which the little pig replied, "Not by the hair of our chinny chin chin." He said he huffed and he puffed and he blew and he knocked that house down as well. They ran to the third brother's house where they began to hide. And he said the same thing when he got there, "Open up and let me in." But they said, "Not by the hair, by chinny chin chin." And he said he huffed and he puffed and he blew, but he was unable to knock that house down because it was made out of brick. But there was one strange thing that never ever caught my attention. But as I was studying for this message, I began to think back over that story about the three little pigs. Never ever was there any mention about a foundation. Never ever was there any mention of them building a foundation before they built their houses. They just simply built some houses. with no foundation. They built houses with nothing to hold them down secure. Now, I think that's why the first two were blown away, because they were using inferior material in the first place. But even as I began to study this, I came across something, too, that said if you want to buy a straw house, you can buy one in California. They make them out of straw. Bales of straw they're making houses out of. I said, Lord, have mercy. But they said they were fireproof. I don't know how that is, but they said they were fireproof. So you want to test one out, you can move to California and buy your straw house. But I began to understand that these houses should have had a foundation. As Christians, we've got to make sure that we have foundations. You see, there is one thing that we've got to understand, and we must notice that we must understand and recognize that our spiritual growth is not a fairy tale. Our spiritual growth is not a fable. If we are to survive spiritually, we are going to have a good, solid, and permanent foundation. If we're going to survive in this life, and if we're going to survive any attack that comes against us spiritually, we've got to have a solid and permanent foundation. And the first thing I want to share with us this morning is the foundation is your starting point. You see, when we talked about in the earlier messages in this series coming soon, we talked about having a view, and we had to have a view, the concept of what we're supposed to look like. We called it our future view. Then we said that the property had to be acquired. We had to become God's property. He's already paid for us. He's already purchased us, but we just have to become his property. And then we talked on last week, we had to dig and dig deep. I hope you've been digging this week, and I hope you've dug into your lives, and I hope you've confronted some things, and you've gotten rid of some things. Amen. And if you're still preparing your ground for a building, then you keep on preparing the ground, and don't put the foundation down until you've got the ground ready. But I want to talk about this foundation this morning. This is your starting point. The foundation is where you have to start. The foundation is what you must have in order to put your building or structure up. I don't care what kind of building you're putting up, you need a foundation. And in the text, it responds and it shows us that we are God's building. But that means that we have to have a foundation. And our foundation is none other than Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the foundation where we start. Jesus Christ is the foundation because we put our faith and our trust in Jesus Christ. That's where we start as Christians, putting our faith and our trust in Jesus Christ. He is the beginning work of our foundation. He's the beginning work of our salvation, but he's also the completion of our salvation. He's the completion of the salvation work that God is starting in us. But not only must we have the starting point of the foundation, we got to understand that your foundation has to be square and true. When you put a foundation down, you have to make sure that it's level. You have to make sure that it's square. If you put down a raggedy foundation, guess what? The house is going to be raggedy. That would explain some Christians' lives. They have a raggedy foundation, therefore they live raggedy lives. They have a crooked foundation, therefore they live crooked lives. Amen, life, amen, wall. I say my own amens, amen. You got to understand, if we don't have that starting point of a foundation, or if it's not true, and if it's not square, and if we don't have it leveled, then we're going to have a house that is going to be crooked. We're going to have a house that won't fit together properly. Why? Because the foundation is not right. And then your foundation has to be strong. It has to be strong enough that whatever you put on it, it will hold it up. Some of us have a foundation that is weak. And it's weak because it's not built upon Christ. Some of us have a foundation that's kind of shaky because we've not used the right material to make our foundation. If your foundation is made up of your intellect, if your foundation is made up of your goodness and your righteousness, you need to trade that in and get another foundation. If your foundation is made up of what you think is right and what you think you ought to do and how you think you ought to do it, then you need to trade that in and get a real foundation. You need to trade that in and get the foundation of Jesus Christ. I don't care how smart we think we are or how intellectual we think we might be, if we are not on the right foundation, if it's not on the foundation of Jesus Christ, we'll wind up with our souls being destroyed in hell. Only Christ is the strong foundation. Only Christ is that permanent and solid foundation that we must build our Christian lives on. Don't let some man come along or some woman come along and deceive you and tell that you can build your life on some other foundation other than that of Jesus Christ. They're nothing but a liar, a thief, and a robber if you're told so. Paul is here in this text trying to get the people to understand that Jesus Christ is the one and only true foundation. He's trying to get people to understand no matter who's building on the foundation, they've got to make sure that they take great care in building on this foundation. You can't put junk on this foundation. We're going to talk about framing later, but you can't just put anything on this foundation. You see, so you can't have the foundation of Jesus Christ and then you want to build immorality on that foundation. It goes against what God wants and it goes against who God is. You got to understand that this is your starting point. And if you start wrong, you'll finish wrong. And I don't care what kind of house you're building or what kind of building you're putting up. If the foundation is not right, you'll have a building that's not right. And if you want to be true and you want to be faithful and you want to make sure that you have a good start and a good solid foundation, you've got to start with Jesus Christ. And if you don't start with Christ, you need to tear down whatever you're building and start all over again. Many of us need to do that to our own spiritual lives. We need to tear it down and start over with Jesus Christ as the foundation. We need to start over and make sure that we've got that solid and permanent foundation of Jesus Christ and make sure that He is the Lord, the Savior, and the Master of our lives and of our souls. And then the other thing that I've got to understand is the foundation is important. It is important. You see, if my foundation is not right, if I've used the inferior material in building my foundation, it can shift. How many of you have had your foundation built on something else before you came to Christ Jesus? And it shifted on you. How many of you know people who shift in their spiritual walk? One day they believe this and the next day they believe that. Amen. One day they walk in with Buddha, and the next day they walk in with Muhammad, the next day they want to walk with Jesus, and then the next day they want to declare that they are Catholic, and then the next day, you're shifting. Your foundation is shaky. You're shifting. You got to have a solid and true and sure foundation. Make sure that you have a good foundation because it's important. If you don't have the right foundation, it will shift on you. That's why sometimes when we get in trouble spiritually, things began to shift on us and we lost and we don't know what to do because we did not have the right foundation. But not only will it shift on you, but your foundation can crack. We got a lot of crackpots in the body of Christ. Amen. Don't act like you don't know that. You've said it yourself. There are a lot of crackpots in the body of Christ because their foundation is cracked. And because their foundation is cracked, they're cracked. And they go around telling people they're cracked, messed. And they lead other folk to build on a cracked foundation. If the foundation is cracked, you've got to fix it. Better yet, destroy it and start with the right foundation, Jesus Christ. If the foundation I'm building on is cracked, it won't do me any good. It may last for a little while, but if it keeps on cracking, eventually it will crumble up and everything that I built on it will begin to fall. Let them go downtown and put up one of those skyscrapers on a cracked foundation. It won't be long before that building comes down. Now, it may look good for a while. It may look like it's steady and stable for a while, but the more the foundation underneath it begins to crumble and crack and shift, that building will start to come down. And in one day, everything will come crumbling down in one big pile of mess. That's what generally happens to us when our spiritual lives are built on the wrong foundation. It'll look good for a while. It'll look like you can stand for a while, but one day it'll all come crashing down around you. One day it will all come crashing down and you'll be left wondering, what must I do? What can I do? And you'll find yourself laying in destruction. See, Satan doesn't care if you build on a cracked foundation. He don't care if you build on a foundation that's a little off plumb. He doesn't care because he knows it won't stand. He knows it won't make the test. But when you start building on a foundation that is true and sure and square and accurate and flat and level, he has concern then because he knows that foundation will stand. He knows that foundation will stand the test of time. But he knows if you build upon that foundation, then he'll have trouble with you. If you build on that foundation, he'll have trouble coming into your life doing what he used to do. Because you built on the right foundation. You see, the foundation affects everything that's being built on it. Everything that's built on that foundation will be affected. Don't you understand that when your house is being built, if the foundation is off, your walls will be off? You'll have a cracked wall over here eventually, or you have a sinking wall over here eventually. That's why sometimes when you go to put your curtains up, you measure 10 inches on this wall, and then you measure 10 inches on this wall, and then when you hang them up exactly like they're supposed to be, the rod is like this. And you're wondering, how did it get off? Somewhere along the way, the foundation was not quite level. It was not quite square. And because of that, the walls are not right. Or maybe you've lived in a house and you see a crack going down in the corner over here. That foundation has begun to settle. And it's settled unevenly. Why? Because it was never laid out and leveled properly. And it causes cracks in your walls. Well, that's what happens to us spiritually. We start developing cracks in our spiritual life because the foundation was never leveled. The foundation was never square and never right. The foundation was never flat. The foundation was not built upon Jesus Christ. And because of that, everything that's built upon it is not right. That's why there's so much confusion in the body of Christ. Some folk have built upon their own foundation. Some folk have tried to build upon the foundation of their intellect. Some folk have tried to build upon the foundation of their money and power. Some folk have tried to build upon the foundation of emotionalism. And they built the foundation, but the foundation will not stand the test of time. The foundation will not last. The foundation will make everything that's built on top of it out of order. You got to make sure you understand that the foundation is your starting point and that the foundation is important. Amen. But after that, I want you to understand you got to have the right foundation. And the right foundation is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, the Bible tells me, is the chief cornerstone. When he was laid in place by God the Father, everything else was built off of him. You see, if the cornerstone is not right, if the cornerstone is not level, if the cornerstone is not positioned just right, then everything that's built off of that cornerstone will be out of order and out of place. But if Jesus Christ, which is the right cornerstone, he's the just cornerstone, if he is right and he's perfect in all that he does, everything that's built off of him will be right, just, and perfect. Everything that's built off of that cornerstone will be exactly as it ought to be. And you will be able to have a solid and a good and a sure and a permanent foundation. Why? Because you started with Jesus Christ, who is the chief cornerstone. And don't you understand? The chief cornerstone holds it all together. I think that's why some of us suffer the way that we do. We're trying to hold it together. Depend upon your foundation. But if I don't have the right foundation, I can't depend upon it. But if my foundation is right, if my foundation is Jesus Christ, and the chief cornerstone of my foundation is Jesus Christ, I can trust him to hold it all together. Amen. You can't hold your life together like Jesus can. You can't pull together like Jesus can. Jesus Christ can hold your life together like nobody's business. Your life can be going to hell in a handbasket, but if you got a good foundation in Jesus Christ, he can hold it all together. Your money might be looking funny. It might look like you're not going to be able to make ends meet from month to month, from day to day, from year to year maybe. But God and his son Jesus Christ as the chief cornerstone, he can hold it all together. Even when your money look like it won't make it to the next month, and it might not make it to the next month, God is still able to hold it all together in his son Jesus Christ. Your health might look like it's failing you and it's deteriorating rapidly, but if you just keep holding on to that foundation, which is Jesus Christ, he can hold it all together. Your body may not tell you that, but Jesus is holding all things together in the hollow of his hands. He is the one that holds all things together, as the book of Colossians tells me. God is using his son Jesus Christ to keep us in that place that he wants us, to keep us in that perfect place, to keep us in his will. We are built upon his foundation. The lives that we build spiritually, we build upon the foundation of Jesus Christ. And if we build upon the foundation of Jesus Christ, we're building on the right foundation. He's able to bear the load that God and the sinners put on it. My God, when I put a load on the foundation, I want to know that the foundation can hold what I put on it. I want to know that the foundation can hold the building structure that I put on it. God can build a foundation. foundation in his son, Jesus Christ, that can hold whatever load you put on him. You might have burdens in your life. Just put it on that foundation called Jesus Christ, and he can hold the load. You might can't hold the load, but you are on the foundation. You need to let Jesus be the foundation. And if you put it on him, he can bear the load. Not only the load that God puts on him, but the load that we as sinners put on him too. He can bear all of that load on that foundation. And it'll never crack. It'll never shift. It'll never move out of place. Why? Because it's a good, solid, strong, and permanent foundation. This is a foundation like no other. Whatever building you build, this will hold. Whatever put on it, it will hold. Whatever poundage is put on it, it will hold. It will never break down. It will never, as the Bible says, will never lose its power. It will always be there, able to support and uphold everything that is put on this foundation. Why? Because it is a good foundation, and it's the right foundation. You see, when I understand that Jesus Christ is the one that I put as a foundation of my life, and as I began to build my life up, I'm building it on the foundation of Jesus Christ. You see, while others are building their foundations on things that will not stand the test of time, I'm putting my foundation on Jesus Christ. And while they're sinking and cracking and shifting, I'll be rising high and standing firm on Christ, that solid rock. You see, on Christ, the solid rock is where I stand. And I hope that you are standing on Christ, the solid rock too, because in him, there is no shifting. In him, there is no cracking. In him, there is no wavering and no moving here and there. In Christ, the solid rock is where we all should stand. You see, the one foundation of our hope is in Jesus Christ, the foundation of the world. The one hope and the foundation of our healing is in Jesus Christ. The foundation of our salvation is in Jesus Christ. The foundation of our freedom from control of sin is in Jesus Christ. The foundation of our joy is in Jesus Christ. Whatever comes our way and tells us in life that we won't be able to stand, we can stand. Why? Because Jesus Christ is the foundation. We built our faith on that is sure and strong. We built our faith on that, the rock of Jesus Christ, the rock of Christ. He is the rock of ages. He is the rock in a weary land. He is the strong and sure defense. He is a high tower. He is the foundation of the church. He is the one that God said, upon rock I'll build my church. Church upon the foundation of Jesus Christ. He'll stand the test of time. No wind, no wave will ever come against it and make it be destructed. No wind, no wave will ever come against it and shake the building that is placed on it. That's why your life can stand the test of time. That's why your life can look like hell is breaking loose all around it, but you'll be able to stand because you got Christ, the solid rock, as the right and the sure and the strong foundation of your life. When you got the right foundation, you don't have to worry about a thing. When you got the right foundation, it may look like it's going to trouble you. It may look like it's going to break you down. But don't worry about it. You're built on the rock, the sure and strong rock, Jesus Christ, the rock that will stand every test that is brought up against it. The right foundation is the foundation of Jesus Christ.
Highest mountain, looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Went down into the deepest valley, looked all around down there, couldn't find nobody. I went across the deep blue sea, couldn't find one to compare to your grace, your love, your mercy. Nobody greater, nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater, Nobody greater, no, nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater, nobody greater, nobody greater than you. Nobody can heal like you can. Oh, most holy one, you are the great I am. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. You are he who carried out redemption's plan. You are he who carried out redemption's plan.
Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high.